as I said, we'll start with all the Matilda's stuff as well, what you're used to talking about. But you've just come back from Uzbekistan. Obviously, it was a promising win for you guys. How are you and the girls feeling at the moment?
Good, yeah. I mean, at the end of the day, we came here to qualify, so like getting the win is what we came here to do. So it was good. I mean, I think there's a lot of things that we'd like to do better in that game, but it was a good result.
What was it like regrouping together with that training camp after some time apart?
Yeah, good. I mean, I think for me personally, it didn't feel like we were away for ages. But yeah, it was nice to come in, nice to have some sunshine. I think everyone was just in a good mood to see each other again, so it's been great.
And then from sunshine to cold, back to sunshine. How does that play a part on the game tomorrow? Obviously, it was snowing, I think it was 0 degrees when you were playing in Tashkent. Yeah. Does it play an impact in the game at all?
I mean, for the ones that aren't used to it, I'm sure, yeah. But I think the majority of us live in overseas places where it does get quite cold, and it's like cold at the moment. So, I mean, I was quite happy we were playing in cold weather because I'm used to that. So it helped me a lot. I think actually coming back here in the heat, a bit more nervous because so not used to it. It's going to be like 36 degrees or something. So we'll see how it goes.
It's going to be extra hot tomorrow. Yeah. Do the gloves get a run?
Probably not, no.
Fair enough. Have you had time to regroup and after that game, and you mentioned there are some things that you would have liked to have done better, have you had time to work through that, or is it just kind of adjusting and straight into the next match for you guys?
Yeah, I mean, we always have a debrief after the game with the girls, and we'll go over more today as well. But yeah, I think for the most part, like everyone kind of feels for themselves like what they could have done better, and I think those games can be a bit frustrating, but I think the main thing was probably us just being a bit more clinical in front of goal.
You're close now to qualifying for Paris. What would it mean to the group to get there and to have another go at an Olympics?
Yeah, it would be amazing. I think like the last few, you know, big tournaments, we've gotten so close to getting something and getting a placement, and it's just been like disappointing to like feel like you've done so well at a tournament but then not have anything to show for it. So I think everyone is like really motivated to be able to have another shot at bringing something home this time.
And tomorrow playing in front of a home crowd again as well must be nice for you guys. Do you get used to the fanfare that happens when the Tillies come to town these days?
I mean, I love it. Like, I think it's always so much fun whenever we get to come back home and play in front of packed out stadiums and have, you know, so many people come out to watch us. I think, you know, so when we play games in other countries, like, you don't have that like home crowd feel, and when we come back here, like, I don't know, like, you just really feel like you're playing for your country and you have them all there with you, so it's a bit of a different feeling. So, and I think everyone always looks forward to being back here.
It's been kind of a meteoric rise as well for the Matildas, especially with the World Cup, just unprecedented levels of attention for you guys. Do you embrace that? You said you enjoy it.
Yeah, I mean, I enjoy being back here and being able to play in front of everyone, seeing how many people are coming out now and watching us and showing our support. I think it's incredible. I think, you know, we've put ourselves in a position that's like probably like a year ago, 2 years ago, we like wouldn't have thought that we'd get this much attention and this much support. So it's been amazing to see the growth in that sense. But I am also quite happy that I live overseas and I can also live a very normal life and just feel very ordinary in that sense.
Yeah, does Manchester life differ? Do you run under the radar a little bit more when you're in Manchester?
Yeah, no one recognises me there, which is great.
What are some of the challenges, I guess, with some of this relatively newfound fame? How does life change for you when you are back here in Australia? Is it a lot of this, hotel rooms and trying to do things away from the public eye?
I think, you know, you get used to it. I think, like, I always try to see the positive side of it. I think, like, you know, people coming up to you, like, obviously supporting you and they found some kind of connection and wanting to know about you and wanting to speak to you and stuff. So I think it's, you know, always like amazing to see like someone's recognized you and you've put yourself in that position where maybe they look up to you and stuff. So I think in that sense, I'm always like really happy and able to be appreciative of that. But yeah, I think like sometimes that could be a bit overwhelming as well, like the amount of people that could come up. But I don't know, I've just kind of learned to not really like care too much about people's like opinions on that and all that, and I just want to be nice and be a good person and just be myself in front of people. So when people come up, I just try to be respectful of that and be mindful of like what they're experiencing as well. So I think now I like deal with it a lot better.
Are there key people on the team or in your family or your life, friends here, that help you stay grounded in those moments as well?
Yeah, I think like for most people that know me, they know that I don't really like attention and I don't really like being in the spotlight. So yeah, I think that's important for me, like when I'm with my friends and with, you know, family and people that are close to me, like it's not like they're hanging out with some big star, like they're just still hanging out with same old Mary and just doing normal things like a, you know, young 20-year-old would do.
Who is same old Mary?
I think I'm pretty chill. I think I like being out there, trying new things. Yeah, I like my art. I'm a bit weird, very competitive. I just like being chill, being a bit laid back, not doing much.
What does quiet time look like for you? You said you like art and things like that. What are you doing when you're at home away from the eyes of everyone?
Yeah, I do like art in different forms. I'd say drawing is the most I like doing, but it's also like a bit of a place for me to get my mind off things. So sometimes if I have too much in my mind, then I just don't do it. But recently picked it back up, which has been nice. Reading, I like reading quite a bit. And I'd say probably the main thing is going to like cafes and just having a coffee on my own and people watching. I think for me, that's for the most part, how I recharge and just have some of my own time.
I guess as an outsider, you probably get to see a little bit more of who you are through your own social media and posting and what you choose to share with the world there. And I noticed you share lots of quotes and poems as well on your page. And there was one that I really liked. It was about how you see the beauty in life, not necessarily in things, but in, you know, people and moments and laughter and things like that. Mm-hmm. What are where's the beauty in your life at the moment? Where are you finding those moments right now?
Yeah. I mean, I like to think that I always have a nice base of just contentment and like just in very simple things that are just like filling my cup up. Like, I know it could just be having a cup of coffee or seeing a sunrise or, like I said, reading a book or smiling at a stranger and getting a smile back. Like little things like that, I think, just level out my overall contentment, even if I'm having a bad day. But yeah, I would say recently the things that have made me really happy is just seeing my friends and even here being able to see my sisters. Like, it's nice to do those things because overseas, like, I'm having long distance relationships with everyone in my life. So like being able to come back and connect with people close to me is really important.
You mentioned sunrise and the outdoors there. You grew up in Cairns, which is one of the most beautiful places in the world. Is that where that love of the outdoors comes for you?
I mean, probably plays a part. Like, we're at the beach a lot and just outdoors all the time going up. So I think I'm just used to that. But I don't know, I think when I lived in France as well, like being in nature just gave me a very nice, like, feeling and always made me feel really peaceful. So I think I just always enjoyed being outdoor, getting some fresh air and just having more of a clear mind.
You have lived in many places through soccer. Is Manchester the place that feels most like home to you?
I wouldn't say most like home. I think once I'm finished football, I won't really go back there. But I like living there, and I knew like the lifestyle and the weather wasn't going to be the best when I moved there, but the football's obviously where I've gone. So that's been good, and it is a nice city. I do enjoy living there. But yeah, I think for me personally, probably like when I'm back in Australia, then I feel more at home. And even being in Holland, like doing my high school years there, like when I go back there now as well, it's also a strange feeling, but a nice feeling of feeling like very comfortable in that place. Like, it does feel a bit like home as well.
You mentioned before being competitive. You obviously have siblings and they play soccer as well. Is that where that competitiveness comes from, do you think?
Probably, yeah. I think I come from a family where everyone was very keen to to win. So yeah, it started off as at a young age and probably carried through and carried my competitive spirit a lot.
I bring up the competitiveness because, and I know this is something you've probably been asked on since, but when you were younger, there's a great quote from you where you said that you dreamt of being the best in the world when it came to soccer. Is that something that still rings true for you? Do you still aspire for that?
I think back then, you know, for me, like what success looked like in my eyes was being the best at what it is that you're doing. And for me, the best was just being number one out of everyone. Whereas I think now it's more like being the best that you can be, like what you can get out of yourself. But I think I have a much more open view on life, and I don't like the idea of being consumed by football. I think I want to have a very balanced kind of journey of being able to enjoy myself off the field and on the field while I'm playing. So as much as it would be very cool to, you know, be the best, it's not really my idea of success anymore, and it's more about me being able to enjoy my life throughout it, have that a nice balance, be able to have the nice moments with friends and family, create memories of football, but also feel like I'm not going to have regrets about trying to be the best footballer that I can be as well.
What are your goals, I guess, outside of soccer? You know, do you have aspirations to travel, or, you know, I know you've done some stuff with fashion and that kind of thing. Is that something that you'd like to explore?
Yeah, potentially. I think I'm, you know, very much enjoying my football, but also really excited for the time when I do finish it. Yeah, I think I am very, like, at the moment doing a bit off the field as well, of things that I enjoy, like the fashion sides of things. I've always wanted to open my own cafe, so I did recently get a coffee machine to start practicing some latte art, which at the moment is terrible. Yeah, I think for me, the only sporting dream I had was Olympics, and now the only dream I have is having my own family. So I do very much look forward to doing that after football.
You obviously, I've seen you've done some work with kids and being an ambassador with kids as well, and that's definitely something that soccer probably connects you with as well. I know you might not see it as much as we do, but when we go to games, you see girls with the bubble pony and wearing gloves and things like that. Do you, I guess, enjoy or aspire to connect to the youth?
Yeah, definitely. I think I've always enjoyed working with kids. I think it is very mind-blowing for me to think of like kids just like copying the littlest things that I do, even like, you know, wearing gloves at the World Cup. Like, it seemed like the most simple thing for me, like just a comfort thing, and then people start copying it. But I think sometimes it's hard to connect with and realize the meaning of that for a kid, which is something that I would like to and try to understand as best as I can. But yeah, I think it's amazing to be in this position and to have that kind of impact on kids. So I think I do try to be very conscious of what it is that I am sharing out there and how I hold myself in the public eye. But yeah, I think I love kids, and like I said, I can't wait to have a child of my own. So being able to connect with kids and see how much they get excited about football and stuff that we're doing, it's really nice to see.
There was a lot of talk during the World Cup about Matilda's legacy that you as a group want to leave behind. Is there something that you want to leave as more of a Mary legacy for people or kids coming through soccer?
I mean, I think for me, like, I've just always thought that, like, me being myself out on the field, being genuine out there and being genuine off it is the best way for me to influence people, just being myself and showing people that I have no embarrassment, or I'm not scared to just be like that, and that if I am just so truly myself, that hopefully they feel comfortable to do the same as well. Even if that is something as simple as a hairstyle that maybe other people don't do. So yeah, I wouldn't say like I am conscious of what I share with everyone, but I'm also at the same time like I just want to be me, and I'm not gonna shy away from that just because I have people watching me as well. I do very much want to be living a very true kind of life, which I think, you know, in the past is something that I've probably struggled with a little bit, being wanting to be genuine in front of camera but also feeling like I needed to portray a certain image, whereas now I'm just like, you know, I'll share what I want to share, but also not share anything that I think is not true to who I am.
Do you have leadership ambitions in that regard within the team at all?
I don't really think about that. I think like if someone's gonna look up to you or make you a captain or want you to be a leader, I think that's for them to decide. I don't think that's something that you can just have as your goal and be like, I want to, you know, be captain one day, so I'm going to do this and that. I think, you know, whether you're captain or not, you either choose to show those qualities or you don't. So I do always just try to put the team before myself and support people in their journeys. So I think, you know, that was a big lesson for me last year, just like not getting so much game time, being on the bench a lot, just showed me how much more I can bring to the team rather than just my performances. So yeah, I think, you know, if that happens, like if someone looks up to me in that way, then that's cool. But I just want it to be from like good intentions, not because I want people to see me that way.
Could you see yourself being the captain one day of the Matildas?
We'll see. Like I said, it's not really like an ambition of mine where I'm like, I want to be this, and if I don't, then it's, you know, a failure. I think for me, I'm just like, I want to be a good teammate. I want to enjoy my time with the girls. And if anything, I just want people to be able to look back and be like, yeah, you know, she brought good energy, and when she played, she did good for the team, but when she didn't, she wasn't selfish about it.